And you're making a bit of a habit of these late wins. How does it feel?
Yeah, not by design. So, you know, you're kind of, yeah, look, it's, you know, awfully, you know, proud of the lads. And, you know, it wasn't an easy game for us. We knew it wouldn't be. And with this, even with the circumstances, we had some unique challenges that sometimes, you know, for a lot of these guys, maybe it's the first time they've faced that kind of scenario. And, you know, for the most part, we handled it okay. And, you know, getting a winner late again just helps with building that belief and spirit within the group.
After the initial kind of elation of winning the game sort of has died down a little, what is the overriding emotion that you have now when you think about that kind of 90+8 minutes?
It's hard to say because, I mean, you're kind of processing everything that's gone on. But as I said, I think, you know, when it happens like that, you just know that there's something there that we can build on, you know, that certainly, you know, we can certainly push the boys to greater levels, knowing that, you know, by them really believing what we're doing, they're getting rewards for it. It's obviously harder when you're trying to build something if they're not getting those instant rewards. So getting those rewards gives us the opportunity to, you know, get back in the training and push them again.
I think when the way the game unfolded, obviously had one extra man, then the two extra men, so it meant that we dominated possession of the ball. But when it was 11v11, I thought some of our interplay in midfield, one and two touch to break their press and get forward was excellent. Yeah. Again, these things we keep seeing, and these things are ending up with us getting opportunities, getting bodies into the opponent's box. Mm. I think I would say you must be really delighted about that.
Yeah, I am, Clive. I mean, it's, you know, we're still, and I don't want to say it because, you know, I'm trying to downplay expectations, but we're 8 games into a new side, a new way of playing. And, you know, to see the guys sort of really buy into it and embrace it and want to play this way, even against top level opposition, it's great. I thought, as you said, when it was 11v11, it was a pretty even game. You know, they had their moments, we had ours. When they went down to 10, I thought, you know, until we scored, we were good. And then we lost our way a little bit. We rushed things, we tried to do things individually, and we actually allowed them back in the game with the equaliser. And the thing about Liverpool, even with 10 men, they're equally as dangerous because their game plan is the same. They prey on mistakes. They've got world-class players up front who can hurt you, and we didn't handle that well. I thought second half was better in just that we stayed a bit calmer, we maintained our pressure in the right areas, and, you know, like I said, they got their reward.
I was just going to say, Rob, sorry. How do you instill this belief that they have, that to keep going? It's something that, you know, you see the response of the crowd. They're still sitting here. They're still believing. And everybody is. Every Spurs supporter at the moment believes that we can keep it going and we can get results, as we've proved already.
Yeah, you know, some of it's just the players themselves. But, you know, we try and do it every day. I mean, anyone wants to come and watch us train, you know, we're at it every day. You know, the lads are hard at it. We train at a high tempo, high intensity. We train as if it means everything, so that they're not just conditioning the body, they're conditioning their mind. You know, that there's no comfort zones in what we do. And I think that allows them, when they're out here, to know that, you know, they've got enough in the tank to keep going. They're not gonna run out of energy. You know, they have that belief that they need to keep going because that's what our training's like. And I think when it happens once or twice, then that just helps build that belief where they stay calm in those moments and find the solutions.
Pedro Porro played his role in the winning goal. He didn't start the first game of the season, and he's been excellent since coming into the side. What can you speak about his performances, and especially today? He had loads of different tests and seemed to have an answer for them all.
Yeah, no, Pedro's been super. As you said, didn't start the first game, but, you know, right from pre-season, he's really adapted. Obviously, you know, with our fullbacks, we're asking sort of a different type of role than they're used to. And I think both him and Destiny, you know, have adapted really well to it. They're trying to learn. They're trying to understand it. I think it suits him in many respects because he's such a good footballer. You know, technically he's a very good footballer, but he's also a great athlete. And you can see today, you know, we needed both Destiny and him to be at it today, along with Mickey, because we knew the speed they had up front in transition. We're going to need our guys to be really on it defensively. And that's the area he's working really hard at, particularly with Matt Wells. The whole back four, all the defenders, you know, been working hard with Matty Wells just on their defensive principles. And I think, you know, you're seeing the fruits of the labour.
Just finally, Ange, it feels as though the team is playing with such bravery. Does it feel that way to you, or is it just a natural part of this growth and this process?
No, it is brave because, you know, it's easy for me to go out and say we're going to play attacking football, and, you know, but they're the ones that have got to do it. And, you know, when you're playing against world-class players, It does. It takes bravery. It takes courage. And in football, courage and bravery can sometimes be misconstrued. It's wanting the ball when no one else wants it. You know, it's playing in tight areas. It's being prepared that, you know, I'm going to make a mistake here that could cost my team, but I'm going to persist because we know it's the right way forward. And again, we've tried to create an environment, a kind of, you know, for want of a better word, a safe environment for them where they don't have to worry about the consequences. Just play your football, be brave, and you'll get the rewards.
Well, Ange, thank you so much again. It's such a pleasure to watch this team at the moment. So
thanks,
thank
guys.
You.
Thank you.
Appreciate
great.
It.
Well done,
Clive. Thank you, bud.
Well
cheers,
guys.
Ange.
Thank you.
Thanks.